Hey everyone, welcome to Showing Up, your weekly video series that helps you show up at home, at work, and in life. I'm Michael Fulpot. I'm an expert in the art of public speaking, presenting, and pitching. So I help people to win the hearts and minds of any audience on any stage.
And I'm Kaushik Kumar. I'm a video producer and sales video consultant. I help small businesses and big corporates create compelling videos and online training programs that sell, influence, and engage.
Nice.
So today we're talking about a case study of one of Michael's clients, Stephen Pipe. So Stephen is the Auckland sales manager for Williams Corporation, and Stephen was asked to speak at a wealth creation seminar for 5 minutes. He sold over $1 million in real estate by working with Michael to remove any potential barriers that were getting in the way of his messaging.
Nice. Thanks, man. So it all sounds great, right? So as Kaushik mentioned, Stephen was invited to speak at a wealth creation seminar for 5 minutes. Now, the problem is that he was scheduled to speak for 5 minutes after an accountant had spoken for an hour and a half. It's rough, all right. So no quick bathroom breaks, nothing, just straight into Stephen's talk. So as you can imagine, the joy the audience might be feeling at that idea. So this leads to a time and potentially pissed off people problem. And here's the thing, Stephen is a salesperson and that's his title. That title can make us see him as a potential enemy. You know what I mean? Some sneaky bugger who's just gonna sell at us. Or we can become indifferent. You know, here comes the sales spiel, it's time to switch off. So the other issue is that with being a salesperson is that by nature, there is a little bit of a belief that the longer you speak, the more chance you have of persuading the audience into buying stuff.
That sounds tricky. It's a tricky problem to get around. So what did you end up doing with him?
So I gave Stephen this sand timer. It's a 5 minute sand timer. And we reduced his talk to 4 minutes and 50 seconds. His only goal was to finish the talk before the sand ran out and make sure that everyone in the audience could see it. Now, to achieve this, we agreed that there would be no selling from stage whatsoever. I asked him to remove any selling language and dominate his slide deck with big, beautiful images and only talk about all the exciting things that are happening in the property development industry in Christchurch and the benefits to the city.
So what was the outcome?
Well, Stephen built liking and trust for not selling, but most importantly, he built integrity with the audience for sticking to his time.
Right, well, that sounds great. So, how did that lead to sales if you couldn't sell from stage?
Well, that's the big question, right? So here's the cool thing. At the end of the seminar, people liked him because he didn't do all of those things you would normally expect, and he stuck to his time. And because he'd been enthusiastic, authentically enthusiastic about his talk and about Christchurch, people literally just wanted to come and talk to him because he didn't push the sale. And what happened is at the end of the night, he sold 2 houses valued at over $700,000 and also generated solid leads that led to future sales of over $1 million.
Nice, well done. And a fantastic case study that highlights the importance of removing any potential barriers that get in the way of people's messaging.
For sure.
Are you still working with the Williams Corporation?
Yep. So I've been working with them for over the past 3 years with seminars, speaking, and sales. So they're a great team and they really invest in their people. I'll put a link to a video testimonial from Matthew Horncastle in the comments so you can check out what he had to say about it.
So whether it's removing barriers that get in the way of your messaging either on stage or on video, we can help. If you want speaker coaching, get in touch with Michael.
And as always, if you want beautiful videos made, get in touch with me.
And we're recording from our space this week, so keep an eye out for updates.
See you guys.
Catch you next week.